Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe's Classic Video Games back with another really cool arcade game video for you this evening. This is Sega's famous G-Loc. Cool game. This was one of Sega's kind of over the top. I think this came out in 1990. For a while there, well, I guess they still do, but for a while there, Sega was making stuff that was complicated, like all kinds of circuit boards in it and special controls and specific cabinets and all that, so that basically the parts from one machine would only fit on that machine. But this is kind of one of those deals. But this came out in 1990. This is basically the sequel to Afterburner and Afterburner 2. Same kind of thing. You're in a plane, you fly up and basically have dogfights, and whenever you get far enough, I haven't yet, but whenever you get far enough, you can actually do dogfights with, like, against specific other planes and other pilots. So it's a really cool game. Now, whenever they, like I said, this was 1990, they did Afterburner and they did Afterburner 2, and then they did this one, G-Loc. Now, first thing, the name G-Loc, I had to look that up to see how to pronounce it. Is it pronounced like Glock, like the gun? No, it is not. Is it pronounced like G-Loc, like Tone Loc? Hey, 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 wild thing, you know? Nope. It's G-Loc, which apparently is an actual term that pilots use, because it, as it shows on the marquee here, G-Loc stands for loss of consciousness by G-Force. So basically, if they get rolling enough, it can make you pass out just from the G-forces of being in the plane. So that's where they get the name from. So Afterburner, and then Afterburner 2, and then this one. They never really called this one the sequel to Afterburner, but come on, folks, it's the sequel to Afterburner. Now, there's at least four different cabinets that this thing comes in. This is the most standard one, the most common one. Well, I don't even know if the most common, the most simple one, I should say. So there's this one, which is the upright. There's another one that's similar to this, but it has a little more creative cabinet angle, and I think there may be some lights in it that go off while you're at certain parts. That one's typically you see in Europe. So you've got those two, you know, this one and that one. That one's a little more fancy than this one. And then there was a full-size sit-down one. So the sit-down one is kind of like, if you've ever seen the sit-down Afterburner or the sit-down Outrun or anything like that. It was one of the big Sega ones where you actually sit in a plane, basically, and it has hydraulics on it, so it can move the whole time you're playing, right? Very complex and very cool. You don't see a lot of those around anymore. Believe it or not, I've heard from tons of operators. The big games like that, they call those the deluxe versions. I think that was actually called the cockpit version, in this instance, but the cockpit version was a lot of those big ones like that, after they made their money, remember, around, you know, for their 10 years or however long they were used, a lot of operators threw them in the trash, took them to the dump, because they just took up so much space that they didn't want to store them. So a game like that is actually really hard to find. They're still around. Some people saved them, and some people dug them out of warehouses, so you will see those from time to time. So they made that version of this, and then they made the legendary version. They made the R360 version of G-Loc. Now, if you've ever seen that, if you've never seen that, why are you listening to me? Go find it here on YouTube. There are plenty of videos of it. They made a version of this game where you sit in a cockpit that is on rails, and you basically do barrel rolls. You can flip upside down, everything else, while you're in the freaking game. Which was the deluxe version, the R360 version. I think the R360 cabinet, they did a couple other games in that as well. I'm not all that familiar with it, but those are very hard to find, because it's basically a ride. I mean, it's not really even an arcade game anymore. It's basically a ride. You have to have an attendant to run the thing while you ride it. So those are really hard to find, and they're huge. So I think all of the ones of those that are left are in good hands, though. They're in places where museums, and places where either arcades where they're still using them, or private collections where they've spent a lot of money to keep the things up and running. But this is just the standard one, folks. It won't be moving at all today, but we figured we'd show it off a little bit. You can see the side art. G-Loc Air Battle, Loss of Consciousness by G-Force. Now, when Sega brought this out in 1990, they had high hopes. So they had just done like OutRun. They had already done Afterburner and Afterburner 2. And like they were ought to do, when they brought this out, they had all their home systems, you know. So they put this on the Sega Master System. Everybody remembers that, the first Sega home system. And then they made a version of it for the Sega Genesis and the Sega Mega Drive, which was the Genesis in Japan, or overseas, I guess. Not in the United States. And then they made a version for the Sega Game Gear. So they even made a handheld version of it. So they used the heck out of this game. They got their money's worth out of it. And then after all of that, it wasn't anywhere near as big as Afterburner was. So it's not a failed game because it still made plenty of money and everybody's kind of heard of it and stuff. And the R360 version is pretty famous. So it's not a failed game or anything, but it didn't do anywhere near as well as Afterburner. So the cabinet's pretty interesting. This is just basically a dynamo cabinet, but at the factory they've kind of decked it out in all of their G-Loc glory here. The control panel has a little bit more art. There's supposed to be a piece around this too that's missing. It says Sega Enterprises on the front. Of course, this thing is not standard on dynamo cabinets, but it's kind of just bolted on a regular cut corner dynamo cabinet control panel. Got some stickers on the side, and the controls are kind of, I don't know if this was the only game that they used this on. It kind of looks just like the controller on like Zaxxon and stuff like that, which of course was much earlier than this. But you've got a trigger, what do they call that? That's the it says machine gun here, but I think they call that something else. But it's basically a machine gun. And then you've got your missile button on the top. And of course, these are the weird Sega buttons that are square and strange looking. And then over here, you've got your throttle, which is on a spring. That's a special controller that I've only seen in this game. It might be in some of the other ones too, though, but it's got a heavy spring on it. And then there's a button here, which is your afterburners. You gotta have those, right? So they use this kind of, what do they call that? Halftone? This kind of halftone thing to shade the artwork. It's pretty cool. G-Loc Air Battle. Very neat. And the bezel's kind of like this cockpit looking bezel. Now, let's read the instructions. G-Loc Air Battle, Loss of Consciousness by G-Force. Destroy enemy aircraft as per instructions. I wonder if you're in the Air Force if they give you instructions on how to destroy enemy aircraft. When time is up, the game is over. Missiles remaining when the mission is over will be taken into the next timer calculation. You hear that? Keep that in mind. Select the course and take off. The beginner is the training course for beginners. That's where we'll be, folks. Medium, after training practice, go into actual battle. Expert, skillful players can engage in aerial dogfights. I might try it just to embarrass myself, but we'll see. Guided missiles will hit only when lock is on your machine gun. And then your throttle forward goes fast. And your afterburner as you hit the button. Lock on. So sight, target. So basically, you know, they'll be on the... Here's the target. There's your sight. And whenever they line up, you are locked on. It'll flash. And you fire your missiles. Catch the enemy plane in the head-up display. And lock on when the circular sight overlaps it. The game's so fast-paced, it's kind of hard for me to tell if I'm shooting them. It's locked on, I hit the button, but I never can see where the missile goes before I have to fight somebody else. And this is Sega's little original seal that they started putting on all of their games in the late 80s to try to prove to you that this was not a bootleg. So there you are. Now, a little thing about the monitor. When we got this, it had this monitor in it. Now, one of the problems with arcade games is the monitors burn up. So operators would just pop another monitor in, right? Look how great that monitor looks. Looks good, right? So we've rebuilt it, we've recapped it. It looks nice, but whenever the screen gets bright, if you look at the top, you will see something horrible. You can kind of see it there. See it? 5 squares. What's that from, folks? This monitor was in a poker machine at some time. Ah, horrible burn-in for a flying game. Now, burn-in doesn't really bother me that much, but it bugs the hell out of a lot of people. You can see the other, did you see the text and stuff? That was basically telling you your odds for the game. This might have been out of a, what's that poker game, the real popular one? Lucky Sevens or whatever. What is it? Pot of Gold. It looks like it was out of like a Pot of Gold, because on those it tells you kind of what each hand's worth and everything. So it's out of a poker machine. Now, like I said, burn-in doesn't really bother me that much. I've mentioned that on other videos. But some people, that's just a killer. They won't like that at all. So to those people, I say, okay, just call up the, go down to Walmart and buy your brand new CRT. Oh, that's right. They don't make them anymore. So I guess we're stuck with it, right? Can't really do anything about it. We could pull a monitor out of something else, but then that game wouldn't have a monitor. So what we're doing, folks, is we're leaving it how it is. Now, you can sometimes get a used television, take the tube out of it, match it up to the chassis. The game's working. We think it looks pretty good, so we're going to run with it. But if that kind of stuff bugs you, you're going to hate this video, because I'm about to film it for several minutes. See you here in a second. How to lock on. Do it like this. When locked on, shoot your missile. My problem is, I don't know if it stays locked on. Like if you shoot the missile when it's locked on, I guess they're heat-seeking, right? So it ought to hit it. I don't know. Maybe I should have been in the Air Force. All right. We're going to try it out. See what y'all think. You know what I'm going to do just for you folks? I'm going to turn up that volume. When locked on, shoot your missile. Beginner, don't use the throttle. All right, let's do it. Got him. I don't know. Too loud, right? It said, oh, I'm an idiot. Okay, let's do medium.
that does work pretty good. Enemies. We're taking damage, people. I haven't even used my afterburners yet. Uh-oh. I think I might have died. Oh, come on now. Targets. I did get 30. 30 out of 30. Boy, I'm great. All it took was another quarter. Again. Deal with it, folks. Deal with it. I got my 9 out of 9. Oh, man. That's not good. Let's get the hell out of here. I'm still on medium. Woo! I need to ramp up that learning curve. Tough. They keep getting me from behind, I believe. Oh, I guess I should be watching my radar, huh? Tough game. Through. Mission complete. I think what you need to do is whenever you pull out in front, it's because somebody's on your ass, so you got to like try to evade them, I think. I can't figure out how to really fly at them, you know what I mean? They're to both sides. I got my 15, people. Keep going. Five enemies. They're gonna be badasses, you watch. Oh, man. About to fly into a wall. man. I got one of them. Might have been him. There's two. Damn, I hit the wrong button. All right, I'm gonna play expert one time so we can see what the dog fight's like. All right. Let's check out that dog fight, people. Let's check out that dog fight. Expert, please. All right. I'm going to get so screwed, but at least we'll have it on tape. Four. Let's do the dog fight. Bring on the dog fight. How you doing, folks? Give me my quarterback. Shoot four enemies. All right, I'll try. I think he got me. I think he might have got me. Shot too early and then too late. All right, that's 4 out of 4 again. 4 out of 4 ain't bad. Man, I hate this one. Not fun. That's why. Can you imagine doing this inside the R360 where you're spinning upside down every time you screw up like I'm doing? And then when you do that, it probably spins around. So tough to fly it. Damn. expert mission, I am not. Damn, again. I'm gonna leave. Get me back somewhere normal, please. No, come on. 30. 30. Does that count? Got my 30. Shoot five enemies. Yes. Oh, man. I died at it. It's a damn good thing I don't have anything to do with the Air Force. Good God, there went another $10 million plane. Ooh. Folks, I hit the wrong button again, but there you go. Now you know that's what G-Loc is like. Fun game, tough for me though. I never was good at afterburner. By the way, we have some afterburners in storage. So one of these days we'll bring in afterburner and you can see what that one was like. But that's good old G-Loc. Now, by the time you see G-Loc, it may have barrel rolled over to somebody else's house. I've been saving that one. It may not be available anymore. You can see everything that is available for sale right now on our website. Go to lionsarcade.com. And we have prices, pictures, and descriptions of everything there. Or you can stop by and see us. We're in downtown Rock Hill, South Carolina. And we've got a showroom here full of arcade games like this. This is just the latest one. Now, if you're not local and you don't want to buy one, so you're not going to look at our website, well, that's fine. Just check us out here on YouTube. Make sure you subscribe. And down below, make sure you leave us a comment. Let us know what you think about this great Sega classic. We will see you on the next game. Fire!